I'll praise you. for you and me, with an unquenchable faith to kingdom significance. Let me say it again. I want you to become that person. I want to be the person that lays the boat at night, staring at the ceiling, saying, "Oh God, my life must count for you. God, my life must matter for you. God, my life must make a difference for you. God, I want to change this world that you have put me in." I want to talk to you this morning about having this non-passive, rather aggressive, burning, unquenchable to make a difference in you. And I believe that God has assembled, and that God is assembling us together to encourage one another and to be a church that is a church that brings about encouragement. Okay, so it doesn't matter how old you are, it doesn't matter how young you are, your life can make a difference in Jesus Christ. If you're a preteen or a teenager, and you say, "I'm just a kid, I don't know how my life can matter," I would excuse you in this room to look at your pastor's eyes and look at you. Your life can make a difference for Jesus Christ. Let no man despise your youth, but you can accept your believers in your family, that on your campus, and where you go to work this summer, be shine for Jesus, and you make a difference for Christ. And it also doesn't matter how old you are. It doesn't matter. You might say, "Pastor, I'm an old guy. Now, that world changes stuff. That's for the younger generation, isn't it? And as long as there's breath in your lungs, as long as God loves you to be here, He has a purpose on your life to change your world. And don't you think that you've been sort of put out of place that you can no longer be effective? What is Caleb? I think that there is a baby that said, "I want to take that mountain with a giant here." When Moses is 120, his eyes will not dim, his strength is not diminished. As an old man, an old woman, as an Egyptian, he will be inspired by God. Doesn't matter how old you are, it doesn't matter how young you are, you have a different perspective. It also doesn't matter what your past is. You might say, "I don't think my life is here, I'm saved. Deuteronomy,
to the right is the gospel. Now, there are a lot of people in the Bible, that God uses, but by the way, there are many, many scriptures that God uses in a powerful way. But there are only a few bold changes in the Bible. Men like Abraham, who believed God as the only faith the world has. Women like Esther, who had the boldness to say, if I promise, I promise. People like Paul, who evangelized the Roman Empire and turned the world upside down with his preaching of the gospel, changed the world for them. Yeah. And certainly men like Joshua fall into the category of world changers. And Joshua for us this morning is the student, who Christ is the model. For us to have a heart like Joshua, we have the heart of a world changer. And we can remember that. If you want to know Christ, your real life, to be a good Christian, that's the word of God. You have a choice to make. If the father looks to the mission of the family, you have a choice to make. If the husband, if the mom, hear these words, you have a choice to make. You can spend your life, and God will be good, if you can get it. But you can spend your life just wandering around through this life until you die. At the end of your life, there will be very little that you need to tell in God to say your life will be good. You can live that way. But you can determine that you will invest all that you have, all that you are, all of your days, that you will invest your life in the purposes of God's kingdom, the kingdom of Jesus Christ, and the human state world will be different. If you die tomorrow, if you drop dead tomorrow, the world lost a warrior for Christ. You have no more days to live where the world wants your absence, not in Alabama's family, not in Alabama's spiritual history, but where the world needs a warrior for Jesus. If you die tomorrow, tell the God of heaven, please, send your days or die tomorrow. And your vision is always God for God. You come to the breakfast table, it's not because that's a big part of business, the crucifixion of the Lord, the Eucharist that we celebrate today. Two sets of truths that we build up in one truth, instead of eight truths, that build with a 2,000 and 2,000 different gospel concepts. More than that, the one truth that we use to have a kind of a creating a number of other truths, Before Joshua became the famous leader of this part of history, he was the obscure, unknown servant of God's goodness in the world of the world of the past. People who change the world with us are people who serve God with faithful loyalty. They are loyal to us. They are loyal to Christ's agenda. They are loyal to the peace of God. And they serve the Lord faithfully and simply say, this is my hand, this is my feet, this is my life. Now this is all that I have. This is the truth. And it's devoted to the loyalty of the truth. consistency. Another way to say it, consistency. Joshua chapter 24, we won't take that time. But to Joshua chapter 24, we're going to take it quickly, Joshua 24. If there are a young man, years have passed, the things have passed, it's Joshua chapter 21, and he's told the first of all, the final verse of life, Joshua gathers all the people together, this is what it says, choose whom you will serve, but as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. You thank God that people serve God faithfully, we have passion for God. People who are five stars so bright, you want to be the best that you can for God. You need somebody who just will be faithful today, faithful tomorrow, and faithful next year, faithful this decade, and faithful your life. Those are people. And by the way, if you're going to be faithful to you, you're going to have to be faithful to you. All of us in life experience that work is sometimes life hurts. Sometimes the bottom falls out. Sometimes life is difficult. And you can't let the difficulty drop you out of bed. You don't know it's so much. Joshua is faithful to chapter 1. Joshua is faithful to chapter 24. But he's also faithful to chapter 7. When they lost the battle, they died. God is healing you and holding you up. You can be faithful to Him.